Yo, yo, what's up? Thanks for joining us today. You're going to get the real. Because remember, if it ain't the real, then what you working with? Of course, as always, it's a beautiful day because we in the man cave, baby, down here at home base, looking to give y'all the realest content in the rawest form. And you know, to the left of me, I got my man, Ego.
Yo, what's up? What's up?
You already know, baby. And it's, of course, to the left of him, we got President Press.
Yo, what's up, everybody?
So we at the end of 2020, been through a lot of shit. This year been crazy as hell. First off, if you live through this joint, blessings to you. You know what I'm saying? If you got crazy memories from this joint, which you should, don't forget and learn how to get better from it. Because just know that shit happens and we get to have lessons from it and we get to apply it. So, you know, the biggest thing is, how can we take some of these, the shit that happened in 2020 and really get clear on how we're going to make the move, most of it in 2021, right?
Right.
So I know that, you know, from start, January 1st, 2020 was supposed to be the biggest year, man. Last year was supposed to happen in 2020. Some good shit.
Sure.
You know, you know what I mean? And that shit just went way, way left. You know what I'm saying?
Way left.
Niggas decided to eat some bats and shit. Niggas decided. shit started getting on planes. Niggas decided to DM me. Don't give a fuck about shit. Shit's traveling. And now we are where we are. But, you know, it's good to reflect on some things. And I think this is some of the big principles that you need to do is you need to reflect at the end of the year because, as we talked about in all the previous episodes, it gives you an idea of some patterns that you have that are working and are not working. So, I mean, some of the big things that it takes to reflect on is, you know, you got to get clear on the shit that was ass, right? You don't avoid it. You don't neglect it. You don't push it under the rug. Get clear on it. Like, you know, how did it impact me and how did I respond to it? So, like, for you guys, what were some of the worst things that you feel like personally happened and some of the things in, you know, in media or, you know, outside in the world that were some of the worst things that you were aware of? Because I know shit's probably a laundry list long. But what do you think are like some of the worst shit that happened? Because it's important to identify this shit and realize how it connected with you and kind of how are we playing in the piece of it so that moving forward, you know, the big takeaways can be applied.
I mean, when I think, like, when you say worst, aside from the obvious, I don't really think anything truly bad personally happened to me.
Blessing.
Yep. So, and I definitely am appreciative of that, like, you know, with everything COVID on, with everything going on with COVID, you know, I'm definitely blessed that my family, came out, through this. Like my family is going to be going into 2021 healthy.
Good deal.
You know, the year's not over yet. So, you know, anything can happen on any given day, but, you know, so my family is healthy. My daughter is healthy. My parents are healthy. My sister, she has her fight, but she's still going good.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm blessed for what I'm blessed that my family just made it another year. Now, in terms of to answer your question, the worst thing for me that like I've seen, it had to have been Kobe's passing. And the reason why is because, just real quick, like, my year started, right? D.C. for New Year's. Barcelona with the bros.
Great time.
Come back. Job got me tickets to the Lakers-Sixers game. I'm watching LeBron, my favorite player, pass Kobe and scoring. 12 hours later, he dies with his daughter on a helicopter with a couple other people.
Man, LeBron killed Kobe?
No, I'm saying Kobe was on the helicopter and he...
I'm just saying, bro.
Don't put that in the air.
That's too soon, my nigga.
I'm sorry.
Listen, man.
That's too real.
That's too real.
Because the crazy thing is, right, A lot of people that knew me from the past, like growing up, like in high school and middle school, I was a Kobe hater, LeBron lifer.
Really?
Yeah, it was LeBron versus Kobe every day. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of friends that will tell you, like, I was not a Kobe guy until he retired and I started to see him for the person that he was.
Shit on your life.
Yeah. I made a song about it, bro.
Posted by the wall while I watch these tables turn. Cause sometimes you gotta fall back and just observe. And when you talk less, more things get overheard. So I just grind the weed, roll a swish and let it burn. But hold up, Lord, I got a problem. Why'd you have to take the mama? Took a father and a daughter, crash and burned a helicopter. Took a black man full of knowledge, whole nation fell to silence. I gotta be honest, this shit's fucking with my faith. So was it fate? Was it fucking fate? Tell me it was fate or is it safe to assume that to us he is a great? But to you, just a name that was assigned a certain date. What's the point of 24? In a day when in the end we all get eight. It's amazing that we're engaged in the life of a king that stood for greatness. While we're all living as pawns in the matrix, I just pray that one day this all makes sense.
Bro, I put my heart out there saying, like, I really wish that I would have, you know, paid attention and would have been more of a fan to him. And I was like, one of the, like, the little tiny regrets that I have. But yeah, his passing was definitely, it struck me hard because it was him, it was his daughter. You know, I have my daughter, Leah, she's 9 years old. And it was just like, yo, you know, like, just think about those last moments, like, where he knows and understands that everything is going to end bad. And all he has is his daughter right there who's probably in fear for her life. And it's just like, it was a tragic event. And that definitely hit me personally. And, you know, inspired the Mr. Bryant song that I ended up putting out. I actually wrote that song like a week after he died, too. Yeah. Like, it hit me. Like, just, I gotta say, this is exactly how I feel. So, yeah, that's probably the worst thing that I experienced this year, aside from, like, all the general things. Yeah. What about you, E?
Damn, the worst thing that happened to me this year?
Yeah.
I know what you're gonna say.
Right.
Yeah.
From a public standpoint, that affected me and the public, one of the worst things that probably happened for the public this year was Chadwick Boseman, Black Panther, you know, yeah. Wakanda forever.
Wakanda forever,
baby. You know, sure. So that was very shocking, and you know, because I know my friends, you know, I know a lot of my friends, we're all into, you know, the Marvel movies and shit, so to see that man go, it's like, wow.
Black Panther,
yeah, it's
bro.
The Black Panther.
T'Challa, you know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
That's T'Challa. Yeah. And that really hurt, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, it's like, what am I going to do? Like that's like, dang, like, there's no more Black Panther?
Right.
And they even said they were not going to recast him. They're just going to do the movie without him.
Yeah.
And it's like, well,
I don't want to interrupt you. I just want to say this because we have to really appreciate that man's greatness because he made those movies while fighting cancer.
Right.
And it's
made
like
those movies doing that.
I don't know how people had the strength to do something like that, but you know, hats off to him. That's an exceptional man. I'm thankful for everything that he gave us. I just had to put that out there.
No, you're right.
He fought his cancer while he made
those
movies.
It's fucking crazy because it's not. It's like a fucking stress to be an actor.
Because behind closed doors, you never know what people do and the lengths they go to make other people happy.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like Robin Williams.
True,
you know,
when he was battling shit.
Yeah, battling depression, but his greatest joy was to make other people laugh. You know, you don't. It's just crazy because we don't value our most truest, our most prized possessions until they're gone.
Bro, remember that everybody clowned him because he looked sick and it was like COVID's hitting him really bad. Yeah. And come to find out, because he posted a photo. He deleted the photo and everything.
Yeah.
And the whole time he's fighting cancer and people are making fun of him.
That was a sad thing.
You know, Black Panther turned into Crack Panther. Like,
that's a damn shame.
And he's fighting stage 4 cancer. Shit's sad, man. You know, just be more appreciative.
Yeah. For sure. If that's so,
Yeah, that was... You know, that probably was, like, one of my, like, I was like, damn, man. Like, Kobe hit me hard, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so it was just those two things in abundance. It was really crazy. Mm. Me personally, probably losing my best friend, you know, LOK. Shout out to my man Kev and his family. RIP Kev. That was probably, like, the biggest thing that hurt me this year. That was really, like, a roller coaster for me because it was crazy because... You know, it was like I was too. It was like I was too sad to be happy, and too happy to be sad. Because, and the reason I say that is because, when he died, the next, I mean, I'm sorry, I had my son the day before he died. Mm. So my son was born, and the next morning I woke up, Kev was gone.
Damn.
So it was like, damn.
It's a whirlwind of emotion.
Yeah. Like, I put my phone down. I remember I had to come into the man cave, and I had to sit, and I had to be like, I remember I rolled up like 3 or 4 L's, and I was like, I got to take this all in. And it's just like, because I didn't know how to feel as a person, as a man. You know, I'm happy my son is here, but like, I'm in pain right now. And it was like, and it was crazy because when my son was first born, I'm going to admit, I kind of neglected him a little bit because I was going through so much pain. I didn't see my other kids for like 3 weeks because I was just in so much pain. And, you know, I just didn't want them to see me like that. So that was probably like the worst thing that happened to me this year, just going through that little roller coaster. But, you know, yeah, but at the end of the day, like, you know, for everybody who did make it through 2020, you got to value that. You have to see, like I said last time, you have to see the greatness in yourself. And you got to realize making it through 2020 was definitely an accomplishment for everybody. So shout out to everybody. You're looking at this video. You made it through 2020. Correct. Pat yourself on the back. Give yourself some love. Mm-hmm. Show yourself more respect. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, because, you know, there's a lot of people who lost loved ones, a lot of people who lost family members, kids, and they're not here no more. So, yeah, 2020 gave us a lot of bad, but you got to look through all that. And you got to see the light in the darkness. You have to.
That's a word right there, bro.
Yeah.
That's a word right there.
Yeah, that's right there.
What about you, Ev? You're not going to get out of this without answering the question tonight.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Personally and worldly, you know. What affected you?
Oh, shit. The worst thing that happened to me personally. Oh, wow. You know, for some reason, I wasn't expecting that to come back to me. I don't know
why you did.
Wow. Yeah, I didn't think about that. That's hard because I try to look at things in a positive light, man. So the worst
thing. Amen, as you should, though, brother.
Yeah,
you practice really what you preach. You walk it like you talk.
I'm out here.
I'm out here.
That's what you should. Yeah. worst thing for me. Honestly, probably the worst thing in like, let's do it like outside. Probably the worst thing that had happened probably, and it kind of goes hand in hand. I'm going to say COVID because, I know it's general, but because it was such a shock to how I normally live my life. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure a lot of people can relate, like being out and about and shit. So like, I'm out. Like I travel. Like the last 4 years has been nothing but travel. I train motherfuckers in a very personal environment with many motherfuckers there. Right. So to not be able to go out, to not be able to sit at a restaurant, to have to wear a mask, to having the gyms closed, that was the cap, bro. Like when gym closed, man, I lost my fucking mind. I did as much as I could, like out there, like on the monkey bars, doing pull-ups on the fucking tree trunks, swinging kettlebells.
Was it the same, was it?
Fuck no, it wasn't the same. I do fucking 25 reps to make anything feel like it was, you know, doing some shit. So that probably was the biggest or the worst thing that happened. Just, and I know we share it as a collective, but for me it was because it was such a foundational shock to everything that I took for granted. I'm like, free of America, I can go out, and it's beautiful, it's summertime, late spring, early summer, go out, get a drink, go to rooftop bars, mingle, work out at gyms. Next thing you know, there's no mingling, there's no gyms,
no nothing,
no dining, nothing. People are getting COVID, people are getting sick. Shit, I had COVID, that shit was wild. First off, I respect any motherfucker that got that shit. That shit is, it's real to a degree, because that shit put my ass down.
Same.
Down, down. I'm talking about comatose for a week. Like, body aches, not moving, can't drink, don't want to drink, can't move on the bed, didn't take a shower, smelt, hot sweats, everything just bad.
I ain't never been that sick in my life.
For all you people out there, you know, you don't think COVID is real.
Listen.
Every person at this table had COVID.
Listen, and I know if I was 80, that shit would have been vastly different.
Bruh.
Vastly. Like, and if I was immune compromised, man, listen, y'all got y'all rights, y'all can believe what y'all believe, but like, nigga, that shit, if you catch that shit, now I'm gonna pray for you. That shit is real. Motherfuckers died that I know. So the worst thing that happened was that. And I think, kind of to go off, like, the biggest shock. Now, the biggest shock for me was definitely Kobe, because I was like, wait, what?
Right.
The fuck?
I was waiting for it to be like, never mind. I was waiting for it. I was like, all right, Ronald.
I was watching the Pro Bowl, bro. Right. Waiting for them to say something. You know how, like, and again, like, I'm not really a Kobe fan, but it's like, I had the Pro Bowl on, bro. Who gives a fuck about the Pro Bowl? But it's like, y'all got to make an announcement about Kobe. I'm not believing this shit until ESPN says it. Like, I don't give a fuck what TMZ says. I don't give a fuck what Twitter says. ESPN, you got to say this shit didn't happen.
Right.
And then they finally broke the game and said, we have to make this announcement. And I had my daughter with me, bro. And I'm just looking at her and I'm looking at the TV. Like, I think that's probably the first time that my daughter seen me cry.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't hold them tears back, bro. Like, yeah, you can be here today, gone. Like, this nigga tweeted congratulations to LeBron. Like, you passed me and he's dead 10 hours later. Like, that shit. It just hit me a different way as a dad.
Yeah, I believe it. Yeah. I can't imagine. I screamed
at the top of my lungs. I was. I had to light a L for Kobe, man. I had to roll. You know me. Biggest shock. Damn. Yeah, man.
Everything went downhill after that happened.
Yeah.
Everything went downhill. Because COVID was what? 2 weeks later? 3 weeks later? COVID was about technically, we started hearing about it late February. Like, it was in the news early February, but it was China. This shit ain't coming here. It's on the other side of the world. Like, we dumb as hell not realizing planes going back and forth all day, but that shit ain't coming here. That's China.
Right.
So that was probably the biggest thing.
Biggest shock I can imagine.
Yeah, biggest shock, man. Just because it was like, what? Like you just said, like this nigga was just on the court the other day. And like to have his, the daughter is what makes it, like him as an athlete makes it more human. But to say that his daughter was in it makes it very humanistic. Mm-hmm.
And you know what his daughters look like.
Yes,
like,
and you've seen them, they ball, like they're just, and they're youth, man. They haven't done anything to even do any harm in the world. They have no sins, like. And like, oh my God.
I ain't gonna hold you, bro. That fucked with my belief system for a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, that shit really fucked with my belief system for a bit. I had to really, like, dive down and look inside myself and was like, why does this shit happen?
Yeah.
Like, what is it that we're not getting? Like, I believe in, like, a higher power, but at the same time, it's like, do you not give a fuck about us? Like, we look up to Kobe, but is Kobe just another human being to you? Like, that you, like, all right, your turn. Like, like, I really had to, like, I had to do some soul searching when that shit happened, bro. Like, now, one thing I will say is, and one way that I try to, like, shape my mind and to think is that where there's darkness, you can always find light.
Absolutely.
Right. Like, it's shining somewhere. It might be dark here, but the sun is shining somewhere.
Absolutely. Right. Always.
And I always try to, like, find, like, the lesson in everything. And one of the lessons that I got from Kobe passing, and it was just, like, appreciate what's around you. And it's just, we all know that. You know what I mean?
Right.
We know that. But it's like, when was the last time you took a step back and was like, damn, am I appreciative of my family? Like, am I appreciative? Because this shit can be taken away.
Absolutely.
Can be taken fucking away. Like,
absolutely.
Bro, I feel like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm 28 years old, and it's like, I feel like my life is a blur.
Right.
Like, I feel like...
Move quicker.
Bro, like, I always felt like when I was in high school, I was like, I'm going to be in school forever. Like, this shit...
Yo, real shit, though. Real shit.
Longest period of my life was high school.
Forever, like...
Dog, and it's like, that shit was 10 years ago. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. My daughter's about to go into middle school next year.
Yeah.
So it's just like, life is this fast, y'all.
Yeah, that shit's crazy, bro. That shit's real crazy. One thing I want y'all to do, and I want to put this in perspective. This is something I've done before. So I want y'all to do this. I want y'all to go, if you listen, when you can, I want you to take a piece of paper, right? Like lined paper. And I want to write down everything you look forward to doing or having or celebrating or people you're going to see next week, right? So write down all those things, whether it's grandma, festivities, all the things you know is going to happen next week. You're going to celebrate it. It's written on the calendar. Boom, boom. So I did this, right? I saw my grandma, you know, job, house, whatever. And when you put it in perspective like this, because you said be grateful. So if you want to be real about the situation, everything that you're saying you're looking forward to next week are things you're taking for granted because you're betting on them being there next week.
Mm-hmm.
That to me, when I did that shit, I was like,
whoa, say that again.
Fuck.
Say it again.
So I'm like, yo, go ahead and write down everything you know for sure is going to happen next week. You're going to see your mom, see how, you know, Steelers are going to play. Your daughter's going to want to come play. She's going to hit you up. She'll be here. Your house will be there. Everything will be good. Those are all the things that you take for granted the most.
Damn.
Because you said you know for sure they'll be here next week. So right. Write down everything you know for sure will be here next week you look forward to. Those are the things you take for granted the most.
Damn.
And I was like, what the fuck? And as soon as I did that, bro, wave of gratitude. I got fucked up a little bit. It wasn't going to be all somber.
Made me think, bro, because I would be.
That just fucked me up.
Yeah, that just fucked me up. Because my number one thing I was writing on there is, like, I'm seeing my kids.
Like, yeah, like.
That's number one thing I'm saying.
Right. But the thing about it is, it's piggybacking off what you said.
Right.
So what does that do? When you write it, it fucking shocks your system. It wakes you up, and it's like, hold on. Let me take some time. Let me see what I'm really doing. Let me analyze. Let me take some time to look and see what's good. And I don't say it to create a somber mood. I say it to be like, yo, where's the opportunity? Where's the opportunity to really make the most of the present moment? Right? We talk about it. You hear about it in abstract and all this esoteric shit about being present. The time is now. All that shit. But like, if you want really something, and that's why meditation is so dope, because it really, you know, when you take time to focus on it, it really puts you in a moment, and some things become clear for me at least.
Hmm.
So those are like little activities I try to do.
One day we're gonna have to break down meditation.
Listen, we here. I'm here for all that shit.
Bro. Later day. I won't mess you up. I'm sorry.
Nah, you good? Yeah. Because it's important. Because then that stems into right. So taking the time to focus on now, and I say that because look at the possibility. Like that shit. What it does is it recenters our focus. Right. So like I said before, reality is how.
Right.
And where you focus your perspective. Right. So the blind person experiences reality a lot different than the seeing person because of how and where they focus their perspective.
Correct.
So I say that to say, all right, so when you take that time to look inward, let's on the flip side, what are some of the biggest accomplishments that happened in 2020?
Because
it's very much the same side or a different side of the same coin.
Right.
Right? It's just about how you look at it. Because some niggas could have been, came up in 2020 could be the best year ever. Nobody died. They won the lotto. They had 3 kids. They got married. Shit is crazy. So, you know, and actually, you know, somebody did get married from our friend group, you know?
Oh, yeah. Shout out to the homie Milo.
Shout out to Milo.
Milo,
yeah.
Milo Hill.
Brandy Hill.
Mrs. Hill.
All Hill. We getting married. You know what I'm saying?
Over the hill.
Yeah. Definitely shout out to them. They definitely did get married back in February, man. Beautiful couple.
Yeah.
Beautiful family. Good. They have a beautiful daughter.
That wedding was rocking.
That shit was rocking. Shout
out. You know what I'm saying? Your speech was a little long.
I was drunk.
It was necessary.
It was perfect, necessary, man. Though.
Shout out to the beautiful women and bridesmaids and everybody else that was there.
Yeah, that was definitely dope. That was definitely dope.
Shout out to the food. Hold on, that food was fire. Mm-hmm. That food was fire. I gained at least 5 pounds that night, no question. Man.
Thank God we got that in before COVID happened.
Yo, for real.
Thank God.
For real, because, you know, that was just perfectly timed.
That was probably the last event that I went through before shit went down.
Yeah,
I lied. I was at the basketball game. I got to stop going to NBA games, apparently, because the last two games I went to, well, the first one was, you know, Sixers-Lakers, Kobe dies next day. Then I go to, I forget who the Sixers played, it was like the Pistons or some shit. But that's when the league shut down.
Yeah, you're drawing, dog. Stay the crib.
Yep. So
stay the crib,
I'm going to stop going to Sixer games because apparently like shit happens.
You're not a Sixers fan. That's why.
I mean, I'm.
It's bad juju, nigga.
Yeah. Really
my daughter is, bro. She went. It was her birthday.
Amen. Amen.
Tough position.
You know what I'm saying? I was rocking my NBA jersey. You know what I'm saying? I was out there rocking my. But when I went to the Lakers game, I was rocking my LeBron jersey.
Okay.
But yeah, yo, the world went to shit right after. So I'm happy we was able to get, you know, Milo's wedding in.
Yeah.
That shit was beautiful. Sure,
that definitely was.
Mm-hmm. What are some things that you come? So first off, I already know off the bat, you've been with us since episode one. You already know some big personal projects these guys dropped in 2020. Mm-hmm. Fucking Story of Ego.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I know why the Cage Bird raps. Big projects, yo. I don't know why I have to say this again, but if you haven't tuned in, please do so.
Yeah.
I'm saying it nicely this time. Maybe I didn't get you the first couple times. Yeah. But tune in, because they're bangers.
Yeah, they are.
You mean? They're bangers. Listen to episode one. We got a little, you know, a sneak peek of that joint. That's on fire. We was all into it. It's good. So I know y'all have personal accomplishments as far as, you know, dropping personal projects that were near and dear to your heart, which is dope. I mean, whenever you put your art out there for the display of the world, that's a reflection of what you feel and how you operate. Man, that's crazy. It takes a lot of risk, and that's big shit. So you have anything else that maybe we haven't talked on, or maybe has, you know, been some other things that maybe haven't been so maybe wide known? But
so my two biggest things, like you said, is my album. You know, I've had friends that told me so long ago, you know what I'm saying, that said I needed to drop an album. When I posted that on Facebook, I know a lot of my friends was like, it's about time. Like, you know what I'm saying? So that was definitely one of my biggest accomplishments. You know, just that the fact that I did it and then I got so many listeners from it. So But other than that, I would definitely say the greatest accomplishment was, my biggest accomplishment was, it's kind of like a toss up between that, traveling outside the country for the first time.
Fire, same. Fire.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was that was a great accomplishment for me too. Once Tracy did it for the first time, you know, he had so many stories to tell.
Right.
And, you know, I knew what he was talking about, but there's nothing like hearing a story but getting to experiencing it yourself.
It's very different.
Yeah. Hear somebody, you can't listen to somebody. You know what I'm saying?
You can describe a rainbow to the blindest nigga the best you can, but that nigga don't know what a rainbow look like.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, so he can always tell you about his experiences, but ain't shit like it when you experience it yourself. And I just remember sometimes, you know, when I broke away from y'all and I just went and did my own thing. Because you know why? Like, I wanted to get used to being by myself, because the next time I go out of country, you know, one day, like, because like we said, we probably going to do that with the bros every once in a while.
Oh, yeah, got to.
Don't take it for granted.
Yeah, don't take it for granted. But I know me, like, I know probably one day I'm going to take a trip out of the country by myself.
Absolutely.
And you know that, like... And that it was a great experience to see how another culture lived, to see the certain things that you couldn't get, like living over, like when I went over there, like when we went over there, like me, I'm a big potato chip eater. I love potato chips. When I went over there, there was no potato chips. I was like, damn, there's no chips. I was like, there's no chips. Yes, there was no chips. Yo. I was like, bro, there's no chips.
No chips.
And I may sound silly, but that's one of the things that we take for granted over here.
Potato chip
accent. Potato chips. You know, whenever you get that hoagie, you want that potato chips. Whenever you go to that football party, you want that potato chip. Mm-hmm. There's no potato chips over there. It's like you sitting around, you're like, what y'all eating for the games? And there's no football. Like, it's real hard to watch a football game over there. It ain't football.
I mean, there's soccer country.
Football.
It's real football. Yeah, right.
There is football. And it's like, to be over there and you have to adapt to that type of life, that was definitely...
It was different. Like,
it was definitely different.
Breakfast wasn't a thing. Clubs didn't open up till 1 a.m. They didn't close till like 6.
Right.
Nobody was awake for breakfast. Restaurants opened, I think, at like 1.
We ate breakfast and went to sleep.
Breakfast
was our dinner.
Breakfast was our dinner.
It was weird. It was fucking retarded.
Was our dinner. We eat breakfast and we would go to sleep.
Yeah, right. And then restaurants would close and they wouldn't open again until like 4. So like there literally was nothing to eat. Like you couldn't get
climb
food.
Climb into the highest mountain, all them fucking staircases.
It
was windy as fuck.
And prostitution is legal over there. But other than that, food was delicious.
I didn't partake.
No, he's good. He was a good, he was a wholesome guy.
Yeah, I was a wholesome guy. But that definitely was.
It was different.
I was too busy catching COVID.
Yeah,
we all did.
I did. Remember, I caught COVID.
That's fucking crazy.
We were roommates, bro. We came back both sick as fuck.
That means whoever was
late. Yeah. But you see, like, and it's stuff like that. Like, that was a great accomplishment for me. And you know what I'm saying? Like, and I remember he was hounding me. Like, he was like, bro, make sure you get your passport. He was hounding me. And I was like, I'm going to get it. And I went and got it. I had it like 3 weeks before we left. So I was cool.
Yeah.
But, you know, I didn't get it last minute. But that was just a great accomplishment for me. Yeah. But between that, the album, and I know I've said this plenty other times, but I pride myself for it, you know, being able to manage raising 4 kids at one time. You know, so like that one thing has taught me patience as a father. You know, like, and that's one thing the hardest to learn is patience.
You got 4 people you can't have a
conversation with. And now for all the viewers that don't know, you know what I'm saying? I relatively have my kids close to age. I have 2 kids that are 2. Mm. I have a kid that is 1. Mm. And I have a child who is at going on 8 months. Mm. So, like, I have my
Hardy over here.
You know, just knocking them out.
You know,
just knocking them out, getting them out the way.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm saying? But understand, I'm established. You know what I'm saying? Got my own shit. I'm 32. I didn't do this when I was, like, 20. Not taking a shot at you. I'm just saying. Definitely. I didn't have 4 kids when I was 20. Like,
I ain't have 4 kids.
Right. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, that was one of the things that humbled me as a person.
Okay.
It humbled me. Yeah. It taught me patience. And I it's one thing that I really pride myself on, because nobody could ever take that away from me.
Yeah.
And I know this year was very humbling for me as a person. You know, you learn a lot about yourself. You know what I'm saying? When you have nothing but time to reflect.
Okay.
So, you know, when you're not really... when you're not in touch with the world sometimes and you're just literally taking time out for yourself to learn who you are, and that's exactly what I had time this year to do. And I hurt my feelings a little bit, but sometimes it made myself happy, you know. It's all about being leveled. You know, you got to keep it balanced.
Breakdowns for the breakthrough, baby.
Yeah, exactly, man. So baby, I had a real breakthrough this year. I can't wait for it to keep going, you know. The show goes on.
The show must go on. Fuel
the
fire, baby.
Yeah, the show goes on.
Baby.
The show goes on. What about you, Press? President Press.
I honestly think something that I feel like I accomplished that most people don't know, so aside from like the obvious things, I honestly think this was the year that I finally made the decision to be more unapologetically myself. And what I mean,
sounds like selfishness a little bit.
No, I'm not. Now, what I mean by that is that on a more just
it's good as shit. Right?
Yeah, the wine is popping. Where am I going with this?
They said, "Where am I going with this?"
No, I honestly feel like I was just able to, you know, express myself. Like, yeah, I dropped the album, but like, it was more about me letting off some things that, like, I felt like I've always, like, held in. You know what I mean? Right. And, like, I put it out there into the world, and it's like, I now feel more free, you know, going in with the title. I know why the Caged Bird Raps.
Okay.
This is the reason why. It's because I got a freeing feeling from it. And, you know, it's like, that's what I mean by, like, I'm unapologetically myself. Like, now people know who I am. Right. You know some of the traumatic things that I've been through. You know, like, how I felt about being a parent. You know how I felt about past relationships. Like, all these things are now put on the table. And it's like, I felt like I was never that type of person.
Okay.
I always felt like I was more of Say it again?
I said a lot of growth.
A lot of growth.
So it was like, it was just more like, I feel like now, you know, turning 28, spending this entire year being 27, like, I feel like I'm just coming into who I am as a person.
Amen.
So, like, even with this podcast, you know, the ability just to get up here and just
Was the podcast. We're all assholes.
Hold on.
Let's take this second to be very, like, gracious for this. You know what I mean? Like, we put this together.
We did.
Shout out to You Get the Real Podcast, baby. You gonna get the real, baby.
Yeah, shout out to the podcast.
That's what it is.
And it's like, yo, like, I'm doing this shit with my brothers. Like, this is shit that I thought about for years, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, as things start to grow, I want to get more of my bros involved because, you know what I'm saying, the whole team got to eat, B. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I feel like I'm coming of age. Like, the Sammy album we rocked all the time.
My God.
That shit fire, by the way. Yeah, so it's like, I feel like that's like, despite 2020 and everything that it encompasses, I'm most grateful for, you know, feeling like I am coming into my own. And that's what I think most people, like, I don't, like, even telling you guys, I never told you guys this shit before. That's what I take away from this. Despite everything. And then just to put a little cherry on top too as well, one thing that I think too is, like, this year forced me to also be a better parent because I spent more time having a conversation with my child because I'm more around her all the time because of COVID.
Blessings.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, before in the past, like, I'm never saying, like, I was a bad parent. It was just more so of you get caught in the routine of life.
Yeah.
You know, you get caught in the routine of going to work, picking your kid up from school, you know, feeding them dinner, you know, doing one activity and calling it a night and doing boom, 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 boom. Like, that's been the fucking routine. 2020 happens. You know, now I'm forced to, like, my daughter, she's on TikTok. She sees the Black Lives Matter shit. So now I'm forced to have these conversations. And it's like, It forced me to, like, yo, bro, you got to be way more in tune with, you know, your daughter coming up in this world because there's a lot of shit going on and you're responsible for everything that she's taking in, all the information she's taking in. Like, how are you going to shape this person for the world that she's going to see when she hits your age?
Right.
Because you remember what it was like when you were her age and what you didn't get.
Right.
So what the fuck are you going to do, bro? And it's like, 2020 forced me to ask these questions because I had the time to do it.
Right.
And I feel like anybody that's a parent of a preteen, CJ, you probably relate, bro. Like
everything you're saying is what I would say.
Yeah, everything. You know what I'm saying? Your daughter's 8, right?
Yeah.
She's 8, so it's like we were forced to do these things because they know, kids know. I'm in a store today. My daughter, we're in the Bose store, and they're playing Star Wars on the TV and shit. If anybody ever watched the Star Wars movies, there's a scene where the black dude, I think his name was Finn, there's Kylo Ren, he's like the bad guy, and like they have a fight scene, right? And this is the shit that my 9-year-old child says. And understand that, I know you guys are probably going to laugh at this, but I honestly and I purposely do not do this intentionally. I don't put political beliefs on my child. I don't put any real true beliefs on my child outside of them thinking for yourself. Like, that's a rule that I have with myself as a parent. Okay, but I'm sitting here watching this with her, and she goes and she is like, oh, this fight is like Trump versus Biden, right? Y'all, I'm cracking the fuck up, right? Because you got bad guy versus good guy. She's like, this is Trump versus Biden. Okay. And then like, yo, and then
she made that comparison herself.
Bro, listen. Yeah, she made this comparison herself. And then what really, like, she took it to another level. And what happens is the dude, Kylo Ren, who's the bad guy, knocks Finn down with the saber. Like, he takes his lightsaber and, like, it goes away, right? It go, and, like, it goes into the dirt. I mean, it goes into the snow. And then Finn's on the ground. And then out of nowhere, you know, like, people that are fans of Star Wars, you know that you can use the Force. So the lightsaber goes into the air and it goes backwards, and Kylo Ren thinks he's about to get it, right? But the chick who's like the Jedi in the movie, she's the one that ends up with the lightsaber. And my daughter goes, "That's Nevada," and I'm like, "What the shit. Fuck?"
That's Nevada. Yeah, I could.
You know what I mean? Like, my daughter's 9 years old, bro. I gotta have these conversations with her. You know, like, I gotta make, because she's paying the fuck attention, and there's no way that I can avoid it. So it's like, 2020 forced me to be a way more in tune parent, and just make sure, like, I'm putting the right breadcrumbs here, so that way my daughter is learning how to think and do and move and maneuver, because this shit's happening.
And it's crazy because you gotta think of it, like, as a parent. Your kids, you know, they grow up and they do nothing but look at their parents all day because they're trying to learn everything that you're doing. Uh-huh. And as he says that, I realize I got to do that shit 4 times.
Or you just get them together at once and you just give them lectures.
Nah.
Listen, I'm only going to tell the 4 of y'all this
one time.
You're all the same age, so y'all can all understand.
Yeah, you're all basically the same. You all understand. Let me say this once.
Right, I got to do this shit 4 times. Consolidate.
You know what I'm saying? Funny.
But yeah. Oh, so everybody listening out there, you know, like, take a time to really get clear on how some of these, especially those with children, because, you know, we're coming of age, we're getting older, like you said, you know, time is coming with us. You know, shout out to all the millennials that's approaching 30, like, it's around the corner and shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know, take some time to really, like, get clear on, like, oh shit, you know, where do I get to go as a parent? Because it's important, because you're shaping your child's life. And I'm just saying, like, you know, just ask those questions. Look in the mirror, ask those questions, because That shit go quick, man. Life is the most, to me, is like one of the most beautiful, fragile things, man. It's like here and then it's gone, but then it's beautiful when you're in the when I'm in the moment.
Deep.
And I can feel it and the senses are hitting, like I can smell it.
That's submarine deep.
I can hear it. That shit is
the Let me get deep. You wanna know how short life is? This is really what fucked me up. Oh, wait, for those that don't know how short life is.
Intellectual. Yep. Error.
Nah, bro, I saw this shit on Twitter one time. I just remember it. Somebody said to understand how short your life is, if the entire existence of Earth was put on a scale of 365 days, so 1 year. The human existence, not your life, the human existence starts at 6 p.m. on December 31st. Mm. Let me say that one more time, because you seem like your head's fucked up. Mm. So if the entire existence of Earth,
right,
was put on a scale of 365 days,
okay,
the beginning of human existence does not start until December 31st at 6 p.m.
Oh, shit.
Like, nailed that.
That's crazy. Shit was popping back then. Shit was going on.
You know what I'm saying?
Dinosaurs and shit roaming around. Fucking
life is fucking short.
Life is short. And new.
Cherish this shit, yo.
Short and new. Holy fuck. Shout out to Mother Earth being around for a long ass fucking time.
So much shit happened on where we're at that we don't know about. Yeah. Like, there's, we first of all, we have to understand as people in the age of 2020, like, there's more shit that we don't know than we think that we do know. Like, that's the first thing that you have to understand. There's so much shit that you don't know. Look at me like that.
I'm sorry. No,
don't do that shit.
No. I'm sorry.
Here you go with his bullshit.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Don't even do that shit. You can show a clip of this nigga we're referring to.
Let's talk about
it. Put a little fucking
I'm good. I was just...
How do you know? How are you informed?
I'm sorry. Because you know where I was going.
Let's go.
No, you're good. Continue what you were saying. At least everybody knows. Y'all know. Yeah. Y'all know what I'm saying, but we're good. It's an inside joke. Go ahead, continue.
No, because despite whatever the fuck he's talking about.
Make sure you get that, CJ, the look, right when I walk by, like...
Always is the fucking look.
Always with his bullshit, every time.
You're wrong.
But no, it's like, we don't know, like, when we go, like, the beauty of traveling, right? Sure. Like, as he alluded to earlier, like, I would talk about when I went to the Philippines, and like, oh, bro, these are just stories. But then he went to Barcelona, and he's like, yo, I'm here, like... You had that thought where you're like, I'm really in a country where my language isn't dominant. You know, like, hold on, bro. Like,
everything I know is obsolete.
That's what I mean. That's what I mean by where you don't really know. You know what I mean? Like, we don't know what life is like in China. We don't know what life is like in India, Russia, blah blah blah. Right. All these different places we don't know. Right. You know what I'm saying? We only know.
We going for the next bro trip.
That shit open, nigga.
I'm trying to go to Egypt, bro. Right. I keep seeing people go to Egypt, and Egypt look lit.
You said you had some friends down in South Africa.
Oh yeah, I got a friend that she lives in Kenya. I want to go to Kenya. I just want to go to the motherland, bro. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I want to go see people that look like me. You know what I'm saying? They don't talk like me.
I understand.
I'm trying to learn. That's like I hope I get to a point in my life, and again, I'm not trying to take for anything for granted. So I hope I do get a point in my life where it's like I can just go and see how different people live. Because life is a beautiful thing, and it can be done a million different ways. I just want to experience the world, bro.
Yeah.
You know, I want to get to a point where my daughter's old enough to have those experiences with me. You know, where we can go to Paris, you know, when she's like 16 or 18. And it's like we can create those types of memories. You know, I'm just trying to expand my mind and my understanding of how large the world is. That's all.
Yeah.
Like, right. That's all I'm truly, like, aside from, like, other little things. But, like, that's what, like, my end goal is, to get to that point.
Yeah, as one should, man. Shit.
So, I mean, that's where I'm at with it. That's what I mean. Like, we don't really know as much. Yeah, that's all.
That makes sense.
That's facts.
That makes sense. Yeah. I never got how people didn't have the curiosity and the drive to want to actually get out and explore. Like, that shit made no... I can't still to this day fathom how a person doesn't want to see the other 99% of the world that we live on to understand...
Propaganda, bro. You're told America's the best place. Why would you go anywhere else?
Fuck! No. Listen, I'm talking about, like... Yeah.
Bro.
Culture-wise, no, I'm just saying. Like, that's why people don't want to go anywhere. They've been told America's the best place to live. Why would you want to go?
That's bullshit,
you know what I'm saying?
Bro.
Go to Vegas. Go to Miami. Go to Cali.
You know what I'm saying? No.
Go see these monuments that we created. You know, they don't want you seeing the world.
Yeah. Okay, understandable. Jeez.
Listen, bro. Like, listen. I didn't... Listen, I know that I had to get y'all to a degree to get your passport. You know how, like, I had to bug you to get your passport?
Yeah, you did.
Bro, my homie had to do that for me. Yeah. Like, because I was in the same position, right? But my homie... Because
I wasn't looking at it like, saying, like, all right, I'm going to get it. Like, it was a priority, but it wasn't top priority, you know?
That's clearly stated.
Yeah, you know, but at the end of the day, once you get over there, your whole mindset changes.
Like my Filipino friend is the one that had to get me there. Yeah. There was no American friend that was saying, yo, bro, you gotta go. Yeah. It was my Filipino friend who'd been there, who did it, who understands it, who's from it. You know, it's like, bro, get your shit, come on. Like, we gonna go to Philly to get your birth certificate.
Thanks for being that friend, man. And you black, makes it better.
Oh, I dabbed you up at the left. That's my bad.
It's all right.
That's some get out shit. You know what I'm saying?
That's a red flag. That's the left hand, nigga?
Peculiar. But yeah, I'm just saying, I had that friend for me too. And it's like, it was a luck. Thankfully for me, it was a friend that wasn't from here.
It was my left hand too. I wasn't thinking about the lift. I was thinking about most convenient.
That's what happened. Yeah. Most convenient. You know your right hand has never touched your right elbow?
Well, it's impossible.
Yeah, I mean, I read that today. It was pretty wild. I was like, damn, that's true. My hand touched a lot of shit. You know,
it makes me cringe now. Like, I can't do it. Like, I'm mad I can't do it.
Right.
Man, that's the only thing on my... That's wrong. Anyway. Back to the bridge. You know, a little thing, a little Snapple cap. Snapple caps. Which, they don't even do those anymore. Snapple cap. Remember them, Jones?
I don't drink Snapple.
They still do them? You don't drink Snapple?
No, man. I grew up.
Oh, man.
Grew up?
Nigga, I didn't know iced tea. Right.
Grew up?
I had an age bracket. Like,
yeah, I grew up.
Okay.
It's like, no, I was never really a Snapple fan. That's all.
Okay. That makes sense.
I like Snapples.
Yeah, no disrespect to Snapple. I was never a Snapple.
That's cool. I mean, you got the drink, you got the flavor, and you got the fact.
I snapped out of it.
You snapped out of it.
I see what you did there. CJ, what you got, man? What's the accomplishment you had, man?
I mean, similar to Tracy, man. Like, you know, it was, you know, being at home with my daughter.
Yeah.
And then, like, just like last week, I had that, like, epiphany moment where I was like, what am I grateful for this year? It's like, well, I had to teach her and had to do work. And it was hard. It was hard as shit.
Oh, my bro. What the fuck are they teaching?
Everybody, put it on your resume. If you had to teach your kids, you might as well just slide that right in there.
Yeah, it was hard. It was frustrating. We got into battles, man. But then, like a switch hit. And I just had to adjust as a parent, had to learn more patience. And I just realized, like, yo, like, when in my life, again, am I going to be able to spend an entire year every day and watch my kid grow?
Probably not.
Like, in, like, outside looking in, bro, like, you can, like, that's a blessing. Like, as fucked up as it sounds, like, COVID afforded you the opportunity to spend more time with your family.
Yeah.
Like, in a weird sense, like, that was some shit that we never really had the opportunity to do, you know? So, it's like, you gotta be thankful for that, bro. Like, you have to, and it's,
You gotta be thankful for your accomplishments.
It's crazy. It's really crazy, because, like, events happen.
Right.
And they're, like, in a sense, they're, like, neutral.
You know who was probably hard for, too? Hard for, like, people who graduated. Like, people who graduated
schools and stuff.
Like, they didn't get to walk, man.
Didn't get to walk. If you were, like, a senior, you didn't play sport.
You didn't get to play nothing.
You didn't go to graduation. You know? There was no prom.
And shout out to and shout out to my sister-in-law. She's on her IG handle is at Deja Tang. Go follow her. She's a dope person. But she graduated with her master's degree this year. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's what's up.
Yeah.
That's a big accomplishment. Hey. That's a big accomplishment.
Yeah, graduating with your master's, that's crazy.
That is a big accomplishment.
But it's crazy because you do that as an accomplishment, but you don't even get the walk.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, I know it's not all about the walk,
but it's important because it's like the highlight. It's like the capstone of, like, yo, my 4 years.
Yeah, my four years. I'm like
shattered on.
Shat it on. Like, just now you're just going to hand me my shit. Yeah. Get on, motherfucker.
Virtually.
Virtually.
You get that gratifying, gratifying feeling that you're walking away from all the shit that you had to do to get.
Yeah.
It's interesting how it's all like how you walk up the stairs, you pass, and you come back down, you go through.
I know some schools tried to, like, some schools actually tried to reenact it. Like, you had assigned times to go to the school, and, like, you and, like, three family members can be there. Yeah, like, I mean, some schools did that. I think Norristown did that.
It was good.
Okay. I mean, listen, hey.
At least they tried.
Right, you know what I'm saying? You get a B for effort.
Yeah, I guess.
Hey, shout out to Norristown. Fuck you talking about. Norristown football, baby, out here.
C plus, meet me in the middle.
You know what I'm saying? We out here.
Meet me in the middle.
Alum. Still love that. Remember my graduation. That shit was fire. I don't know about y'all niggas. You probably graduated when they still had fucking
VHS tapes.
VHS tapes. I was gonna say the camcorders that you got rolling shit, but
VHS. Chill out. I'm not that old.
Niggas like,
chill
ain't, out. Niggas chill ain't out. Have HD yet.
Chill out.
Did you see a smart board? You know what that is?
Nah, damn, man, that's crazy. That's
definitely
crazy.
Had smart boards back in.
That's crazy.
Smart boards are crazy shit though.
That's crazy.
Wow. Smart boards are wild as fuck. I think one of the biggest eye-opening things for me, and granted, I'm 29, but 30 is next year. Mm. And it's how you look at it. As I was saying, everything, like, no matter what you think, like, 13, oh my God. Girl, was it? I think it was Gandhi. I'm pretty sure it was Gandhi. I read this, or I heard somebody speak of their interaction with him, or maybe it was a book they read or some script. So long story short, enough. I'm almost positive it was Gandhi. I think the Chinese, there was a war with China and India, correct, you know, punching the facts. I'm obviously paraphrasing like shit right here. But they basically, like, was, like, killed his people, And I think they did an interview and they asked him, you know, like, how do you feel? Aren't you upset? Aren't you sad? Aren't you, you know, aren't you depressed from all this? And he said, they already took my land. I'm not going to give them my mind and my emotions too. Mm. So the situation was neutral. And actually, you know, the guy, what was the guy? Victor, the book, it was the, he was the, he was the Nazi, the guy, his, I can't remember.
Victor Crumb. Wait, no, that was Harry Potter.
No, not Harry Potter. I can't remember the name of the book, but Victor, punch his name to find out who it is.
So he's flagged.
So essentially, so this guy's, so this was a Nazi, right? So his family got kidnapped. His wife and I believe his daughter were killed. He was held prisoner and he like wrote a book and like was like at peace throughout the whole thing. And he was eventually, what I'm saying to go through 360 is events happen, but we dictate the meaning of them. Right? Tony Robbins says it really gets like life has no meaning. Words have no meaning. You just assign it to them and you'll react in accordance.
I like that. I like that.
So, but and it's hard because we've been ingrained in like news and propaganda shit, like wired you to respond a certain way. And like our beliefs are based on that. If it rains, I'm going to feel sad. Oh shit, it rained. Fuck the rain. Right. But we don't always see it like that. But
you have to agree with whatever's going on to evoke any emotion out of yourself.
Exactly. And we talked about earlier, right? Agreement's the first part. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? Like, if you call me ugly, I have to agree with you.
Right. See? He gets it. Come on, baby.
You know what I'm saying? If I really don't give a fuck about what you say, like,
and
bro,
it, and it actually slips right off like water. Like, it's like water beads. Water. Like, boom.
And then once you understand that that person's only speaking from their own perspective, it's like,
spit that shit.
Bro, I really don't care. You know what I'm saying? Spit like, I'm shit. Going to do it. Like, I got to wake up and pay these bills. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Exactly. Like, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I don't pay your, I don't pay attention to you because I have to pay bills here. So it's like,
ask me that, Joe.
I was sorry.
But one of the craziest things that I was going to say about it being like, you know, perspectives and blessings and shit, because like it's really our choice to make it. Like it's our choice to dictate how it's going to fucking influence us. Get out the rat race, you know, be your own person. Think for yourself, as Chris always says. It's like one thing that was crazy to me, and I'm 29. Next year, if I'm blessed again, right, I'm speaking in the future tense, if all blessing is to see my life, this time next year, I would have lived longer and been on this earth longer than my dad was.
Nigga.
So that, for me, was crazy. I was like, yo, I was thinking about it. I'm like, yo, bro, when I'm this time next year, if I'm alive, God willing, I would have lived longer on this earth than my dad did. I was like, what the fuck? Because nigga, he died a week after his 30th birthday. Wow. So I'm like, damn. So I kind of feel a little some way about 30. I'm like, yo, 30's kind of like, that ain't the greatest year.
You know, ain't the greatest year.
It ain't got it for like our family and shit. But again, not to be somber and shit, because I'm blessed. A lot of great things have happened.
I'm going
to
speak that shit in existence. You going to be here, bro. We gonna
oh, baby, I'm saying. You got to take me out, bro. You got to hit me hard, dog. Like, you got to fuck with me. You got to
get bowling. We going to go hard now.
Because a lot of the bros turn 30 next year.
Yeah, they do. Shout out to the 30 club. You know, we don't run from it. We run to it, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all might as well just put together one trip.
Just so you can't call me old no more.
When we get to 30?
Yeah, you can't.
Because no one understand your pain.
Exactly.
I got arthritis and shit.
But, you know, even though you get old, still work out. You know, don't because you hit 30 doesn't
you just hang out
trouble.
With older people. That's all that is.
I know.
But so you can't brag about being a younger person.
I don't brag about being young.
You're right, you don't.
30, first off, 30 is not old.
Yeah, it's
not. 30 is not old from any point. Not even like
bro, it's I don't think 50 is old. Angela Bassett can get it.
You're prime. Yeah, you're prime.
If we were talking about women that can get
bro,
it,
bro, J-Lo 50. Let's really talk about it.
I don't want to talk about this.
Because we'd have been here for the next 3 hours.
What?
Right. But yeah, man, there's a lot of
50-year-olds I could put a ring on if I could. Jeez.
So for instance, like, you know, one of my homies in Germany, you know, Spantana is his Instagram handle. So like, he made the World Baseball Classic roster for the team in Germany. He was hired as a full-time position as a coach in strength and conditioning for tennis. He started his first No Ego performance camp for soccer professionals, right? So he's training like professionals over in Germany. And he also got a sponsorship deal with AM Sports, all right? So that's like something that he's making work amidst interpersonal, like basically.
I be seeing him working. He be working, yeah.
Oh, yeah, my man. Yo, follow him. He be doing some shit, man.
Yeah.
He be doing some shit.
I didn't know he was battle like that.
Yeah, he was battle. That's my nigga in the game, bro.
Yeah. I'm trying to get out there. That's all I want to go out.
Yo, he in Germany. Like, I'm trying to go out there and get some shit popping.
Germany's got to be a move. Shout out to Julius. Yeah, man.
Germany's got to be a move.
Yeah, definitely. That's the homie right there.
But 2020 has been dope. That's why I said it was hard earlier to kind of think of anything bad things.
Right.
Because, like, I've been blessed. Like, a lot of new shit happened to me. I don't like talking about myself. But, you know, it's a good year, you know. I was able to join the greatest fraternity on earth, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to the bruh.
I see you doing your Gene Simmons, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, to any person that didn't understand, this is not Gene Simmons, okay? This is the greatest fraternity on earth, the Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Shout out to the bruh. Shout out to me, Omega Chapter, Philly Q's, baby. We out here. We already know what to do, baby. You know, but it, you know, just blessed, right? Blessed to be able to get to it. And that added to a lot of growth, right? And, you know, just being able to come up job-wise, being able to come up, you know, knowledge-wise, as far as finances, right, investing in stocks, getting clear on a lot of things that we're missing. And, but some of the biggest things that, you know, I look for to 2021 is being able to move out, right? So, I didn't hit my goal for being able to move to Creole and still with Granny. Love you, Granny. Shout out to Granny, my backbone, you know what I'm saying? Right, yeah, me and Norristown. But, you know, get to have my own space and move out. That's one of the big things for 2021. And, you know, kind of, you know, take my career a little higher, start doing some projects, like some books, some mentoring things I want to get into.
Some books? You going to write a book?
Thinking about writing some ebooks and stuff like that. Yeah, man. Oh, try to transcribe some knowledge and shit, you know, because niggas be thinking some shit, right? You know what I mean? Just a little something. You mean, it ain't nothing crazy.
Author Ev, I see.
But, yeah, so, I mean, what's some of the big things that you've had maybe... You know, because we had our past guest, Darnell, he talked a lot about, like, writing shit down and goal setting, you know, and really being able to focus on things like that. So what are some of the things that you've really accomplished in 2020, or excuse me, that you missed in 2020, that, you know, that how you can look into 2021 is to kind of double down on that? Is there anything that you were like, damn, I fucking completely fucked that up?
I'll let you go on this one first.
2021 goals?
Yeah, what you got? What's some big things that you're looking forward to? I mean, like, the conclusion of 2020 and everything that it has taught us based on the last... seven episodes and 56 minutes of this one.
But also, what didn't you accomplish that you wanted to accomplish? I think, didn't you say that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All
right, that's a big question.
Mm-hmm. And also 2021 goals.
All right, I mean, okay, I got it.
Just give him the goal. Though.
Intellectual.
Give him the big ones.
Here you go, you're hot. Give
him the big goal. I am.
I mean, I am too, but... so one goal that I missed this year, and it was largely due to COVID, was this year was going to be the year that I started putting the right, pieces in place, to be able to buy a crib. I wanted to buy a crib in 2021, and I wanted to spend 2020 building up to that. So COVID kind of pushed that on the back burner. Mm-hmm. So now I'm moving that goal to 2021. To put myself in a position in the beginning of 2022 and buy a new crib. Like, that's
okay.
Like, so, it's like, that's I'm trying to crawl it before I walk it type thing.
Gotcha.
So,
I like that.
But the action is getting taken, baby. That's the important.
Yep. So, I'm speaking that into existence. Another thing, too, is,
it's good.
From a,
yeah, this nigga,
bro.
That's your man.
He is my man. You know what I'm saying? Love you to death, bro. That's my guy. You know what I'm saying? This is my guy.
Ad lib, the king, dog.
I am sorry.
You're going to have to ad lib one of my songs one day. Speaking of that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Early in the. I plan to release my second tape early in the spring. Due to some past events, I'm aiming to make this entire tape solely myself, no features.
Okay.
I'm not going to speak on past events. But due to those, I'm going to make that project. If there's anybody that's going to be featured on, it's probably going to be E.
Okay. You got any teasers?
The next title of the project is going to be called The Show Goes On.
Okay, I like
it. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's the title for two reasons. I gotta shout out my man E, because he definitely helped me set it up. You okay. know, we sat over there, smoked some weed, yep. thought of some ideas, bringing them to life. Like, that's right. just been the process, you know what I'm saying, for okay. the past couple months. I mean, well, about a year and a half now, the way we've been working.
Right.
But The title, the project's gonna be called "The Show Goes On." The intro, the song I'm about to let y'all hear, is gonna be called "The Show Goes On," and this project is called that for two reasons. Number one, I'm giving you guys a show. It's going to be, you're not gonna expect, you don't know what to expect. You're okay, going to get you're getting an entirely different sound from
okay.
me. First project was a little bit more personal.
Okay.
Oh shit.
This project is gonna be a little bit more versatile.
Oh shit. Okay.
You see what I'm saying
personal,
there?
Versatile, baby. Let's
yeah,
go.
You're getting different flows. You're getting different concepts. You're getting different beats. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to channel my favorite rapper of the old, my homie Kanye. Before okay. Kanye, I mean before Kim. Wrote that in the bar. but yeah. And the other part of that is it's you know, you're just getting another chapter of my life. Beautiful. So, the show goes on. Here y'all go.
Boom! Let that shit play, nigga.
Well, let me tell everybody about what I did with my life. At 21, I made a killing off of selling that wipe. By 26, I sold a lot, I made a mill, I'm so rich. Psych, I'm joking, I ain't do none of this shit. I'm as confident as Curry, pulling up on the fast break. Mind is in a golden state, but today, I had me a long day. Man, I feel like Kanye, way before Kim, K. Caprende. Homie, I ain't come to play, but I just say what I wanna say. And if you're in my way, then I will kick you in your fucking face and bust right through the gate. The bird is out of his cage, I found my way to the stage. But before those curtains raise, there's some shit I gotta say. So fuck your pardons and comments, cause honestly, I'll never need it. Born from ashes like a phoenix, that's a reference to the prefix. Been manifesting my dreams, my demons are non-existent. Going hard for my team, every day is forfeiting inches. If you do not get the picture, let me paint a better image. I'm like Popeye off the spinach, mixed with tennis as a menace. If you start it, I will finish. I'm the wolf in the meeting, I'm not fucking leaving.
The show goes up.
And if you hate, I'ma tell you.
The show goes up.
And if you hate, I'ma tell you.
The show goes up.
I'm in a spaceship, that shit don't make sense. This shit's amazing, the places in my mind that I can create. And if you hate, I'ma tell you.
The show goes up.
And if you hate, I'ma tell you.
The show goes up.
I'm in a spaceship, that shit don't make sense. This shit's amazing, the places in my mind that I can create. We just wanna party, we ain't bothering nobody. We just wanna party, we ain't bothering nobody. We just wanna party, we ain't bothering nobody. Shaking bacon, these haters, my new name is Ricky Bobby. We just wanna party, we ain't bothering nobody. We just wanna party, we ain't bothering nobody. We just wanna party, we ain't bothering nobody. Shaking bacon, these haters, my new name is Ricky Bobby. And if you hate, I'ma tell.
Ooh, that shit was hard as fuck. Yo, tell me y'all wasn't rocking with that shit. Listen, man, 2020 has been blessed. You got a little bit of some shit to get you through 2021, baby. Celebrate this. Play it at the Christmas festivities after dark, you know what I mean, when everybody on their shit. Playing on New Year's, you know what I'm saying? Because I know y'all ain't going to real social distance like that, but it's all good because the banger going to make it work. Wow. Cool. Loved it. Appreciate you. As you get, we love you, baby, because we do it for you. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to that, man. Show goes on, baby. That shit was fire. Fire. That shit was fire, dog.
Totally.
That shit was
like, fire. Yeah, yo,
I love that. Yeah, I love
that. The show goes on.
My show goes on! Ah! That shit hard.
That shit was
tune
hard.
In, baby. Tune in, baby. Okay, so big project, man. That's huge. I mean, mm-hmm. It already sounded different from that song based on your last one. So, dope. That's a big-ass acknowledgement. So, yeah, drop that sophomore album, man, and let that shit rock. Rock mm-hmm. the streams, baby. Rock the streams and tune in.
Yep.
I love it. That's beauty right there. That's it, my niggas. You know what I'm saying? That's because, you know what I'm saying? 2021 just gets to be fucking fire, bro.
Yeah.
That's how I'm feeling. Like, I don't know what 2020 here, 2020 did his lessons, but, oh, y'all get y'all superpowers?
Yeah, bro. My I got mine, bro. It's insomnia.
It's insomnia?
I mastered the skill of staying up all night last night for some reason. I don't know what the fuck it was. Yo.
Shout out to all the black folks that got their superpowers.
I got
shit.
My superpower early then because that's just me every night.
Yeah?
Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yo.
No, yo.
That's funny as shit. I ain't get that much, man. My shit was kind of weak. I could talk to like fishes and shit. It's not that dope. It's being mixed and shit. It's all good. But anyway.
Sure, that wasn't true.
But that was
shrooms. Definitely might have been shrooms.
It's like no.
If you ain't take shrooms in control environment.
So that's what you accomplishing for 2021.
Yeah, last thing is also seeing a new country. I want to see a new country.
Not a new country. Okay. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Gotta get out there, man. Challenge yourselves. Get out there, man. 2021, the world open up. Go do some shit. God damn it. I feel like y'all got an itch. Y'all gotta have an itch. Yeah. You know y'all ain't this shit. Y'all gotta have an itch.
I want to throw this out here. Because we got to know what your plans are and your plans are too. But I just want to throw this out here for y'all too. What are y'all just, you know, let's just put it on a record right now.
Okay, what we doing?
Every year, at the end of this, and we can make it public too. I don't know if y'all really do it. We're going to put this on tape. So I want to talk to y'all about it. We list like our 10 biggest fears or things that we don't want to do. And each year, we tackle one of them.
Okay.
That's fine, but I'm not. There's a few I'm not tackling. Oh. I'm just letting
you
know.
You're not with the shits.
I'm with the shits, right, but you're not.
You're not with the shits all the way.
What is it?
You're what? A couple of them?
Yeah. Were you done, Tracy? Is that it?
Heights. He's not pushing me out of the plane. I'm not jumping out of the plane. I'm not bungee jumping. I'm not bungee rope jumping. I'm not doing nothing that contains heights.
Sorry to the people that watch the show. We can't hold him accountable to it.
Holding a snake. You can know.
Really?
That defeats the whole fucking purpose of the experiment.
I'm sorry. I'm not doing it.
Like, it's not things that's that you're scared of but comfortable with. You know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck?
What
the fuck?
Listen, however you want to put it, bro. I'm with it. I'm with it. But you're not pushing me out no plane.
Can I push out a plane?
No. Okay. No. I survive, you got to rumble me. You have to rumble me. You got to rumble me.
If you really want to fight after you just dropped for 11 minutes, yeah. 14
y'all can get in the ring. Y'all can throw the gloves on. Y'all can get in the ring. I'll buy the gloves. I'll buy the boxing space.
I'll know it's because.
Yeah.
You can knuckling, because I got bad shoulders. So you can knuckling. You know what I'm saying?
Push me out the
plane. And I'll pay for the venue.
I can see you be like, come on, man. Like, get out the plane.
Because I'm going to be right behind you.
Yeah. Like, and you're like, what?
You going to do it.
We'll jump out the plane.
He'll rumble you.
I'm definitely, I'll pay for the venue.
I'm not even going up there. I'm not even going to waste y'all time.
We're
going
to do some shit. We got to climb some heights. She needed on when it opened up? The balloon at the zoo.
What's your 2021 save goals?
2021 save goals?
Because you're not going to do anything daring, so.
Fuck that. We're going to get me going to balloon at the zoo.
What the hell? Why y'all want me to get me to do fucking
You
got to
conquer shit, bro. We got to be about this life.
It's not about heights. It's about conquering your fears.
That's too high.
Conquering your fears, man. I want to hop in the fucking cage. Y'all know what's going to happen.
Like I said, maybe one day. You know, holler at me in 10.
10 years. When are you going to be comfortable as shit? Fuck out of here, boy. You better not be, but I don't like the likelihood. Dude.
Right.
Life is now.
Man.
What's your 2021 goals?
Let's see here. 2021 goals.
Yeah, the big ones. The gold, baby. The gold. What we got?
The one I didn't accomplish last year, but I wanted to accomplish. I wanted to reach 10 grand in my savings. I almost got there, but I didn't get there.
Okay. Would you buy something? Usually, it keeps going up. I mean,
4 kids, you know.
Yeah, yeah, gotta, yeah. My ignorance for that.
Yeah, it's all right. You know, so I almost got there.
Just another checking.
I almost got there, but I was like, damn. But that was the one I didn't accomplish. But 2021, I'm like my man said, I'm definitely going to see a new country.
Yeah.
Most likely Amsterdam. Mm.
You, of course.
Most likely Amsterdam. So I'm definitely going to see a new country.
You know they grow plants in other countries too, right?
Listen, I just want to do Amsterdam. I want to do Amsterdam. Let me do me.
It's a bucket list.
Let me live. You know, but I'm also going to drop, you know, I'm like my man's here, I'm going to drop another project.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Mine will probably, I don't know when mine will be out yet. I don't like to pick the dates and time of the season just yet.
Okay.
But it's definitely going to be by fall or before.
By next fall?
Yeah, by next fall or before.
Or before, okay.
But
okay.
Definitely. I'm not going to release too much right now, but we good, but I'm definitely releasing shit.
Okay.
You know, I'm about to take the game by storm, actually.
Okay.
But my biggest probably thing I want to accomplish my next year is just be a better me.
Okay.
That's not me saying I want to be a new me, new year type of thing. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying
what does it look like? What's something, if how could you tangibly know? Like, how could somebody hold you accountable and be like, oh yeah, you checked them off?
Say that again? What?
How could somebody hold you accountable and be like, yeah, you checked that box?
Oh, check that box.
What does it look like?
Definitely bigger savings. Bigger savings. Bigger house.
Well, $600 refund check.
When you send it back, you want the $2,000.
Shout out to Trump. Whoa. Trump. One time that I will ever say this, shout out to my man whoever wrote his shit that he needed to write to read, because clearly he wasn't going off his head. For the nigga saying, fuck the 600, we need a 2,000. Shout out to the two bands. That's it. That is it. On record as saying I that mean, for specifically more money. That's it.
In football terms, we call that a Hail Mary. You know what I'm saying? He's trying to do whatever he can to win the game.
Yeah, so yeah, I ain't say all that other shit. I don't give a fuck about that other shit. Just shout out to the fact that this nigga said that. His words. Because it impacts us. So
you're saying cool. Shout out to the quote, not shout out to him.
Yeah, shout out because him, he had to read it. Okay. Because it wasn't nobody else, so shout out to you for being up there to read it, nigga. If it was anybody else, I'd be like,
shout out to him for being said.
Yes. By him. Who it happens to be Trump. That's about, yeah, let me clarify that. Not him as a person, but just him being at the podium at that time.
Right.
Fair enough.
With the word.
There. I get you. I'm just
yeah, there,
you.
There it is.
Yeah.
There it is. That shit struck some nerves.
Oh,
no. Man. Seats. Got some people out of their seats. I know avid Trump supporters too. So fucking funny. It's really crazy.
Yeah, I got two. Shout out to them, yo.
Definitely.
I got a couple that look out for me. I'm going to give it a damn, bro. I ain't with all that cut off the Trump supporter shit, bro. I got a couple real ones. I'm just fuck with you. I mean, I'm just keep it a beam.
Right.
No, you do too, bitch. Don't look at me like that. You know the same ones I know.
I know.
Well, the same one. I'm not going to make that plural. Yeah. Let me rephrase that. I'm not going to make that sentence plural. I have one. You know what I'm saying? He's a good guy.
Yo, so real quick, though, on some real shit, though, come January, so here's the thing. You know, like, one of the most famous fucking things that happens in the world is niggas be like, new me, new year, new me, I want to be healthy and shit, let me go to the gym. It's like statistics. I think
I gave
like,
that
fucking
up like 3 years ago.
I'm like, I'm about to give you bars.
Pipe dream.
Nigga, fuck out of here, dog. Get your fucking health as well, baby. Get in the fucking gym, dog.
I hear you.
Get in the fucking gym, dog.
Talk to him.
I'm about to get real. But anyway, let's listen. No. Just say that, like, people fucking, the highest, I think it's like some astronomical increase in fucking gym new memberships, and then a month later, the shit drops right back to the fucking standard. So, what are you doing? Like, what are some habits that y'all are creating? Like, what are some practices that y'all gonna do?
I got
do?
My gym. What you talking about? I got my gym.
Mm-hmm. Because well, the money all, come out of your account
you
every month, don't mean you're going.
You go to?
We Fit.
We Fit.
We Fit. I go to my gym every day, faithfully,
you,
baby.
You know why I support? I'm about to get real. I'm about to get real.
Oh, damn, come
about
on.
To talk, listen,
damn.
I'm about to talk to y'all niggas.
I was trying to crack a jokey
here's
joke.
Here's the thing, because right now what you're doing is you're reinforcing habits right
okay.
now. You're reinforcing some practices that are hindering your health. You know, the thing as a black man and as a young black man, we have a lot of high prevalence of certain
don't
things.
Don't attack me.
I'm talking about both of y'all. Tracy's just not looking at me.
Oh, this is for him too?
It's all y'all niggas.
Oh, sit here with me then. Niggas. Yeah, get these bars.
Everybody listen. Black men, black women, young, old, middle-aged, whatever, man.
Talk
take care of your health. Help
convict them.
But you got to be clear on why you want to do it. It's got to be important. It's got to be connected, right? It can't just be because it's the trend. It can't just be because, you know, I want to lose 6 pounds. Why do you want to lose 6 pounds? Think of it from a deeper emotional perspective. Like, when I get older, I'm not going to want to be the strongest nigga. I'm going to want to be strong enough and healthy enough to be able to still play, throw football, run around, carry my daughter on my shoulder, pick up my baby, whenever it is, when I'm 50, 60 years old because I take care of my body.
You painted that picture.
Yes, okay. Exactly. That's what I want to do.
I fuck with it. That's great advice.
That's
I never
it.
Look at it like that.
You know what I'm saying?
I never look at it like that.
Yeah.
I just want to be able-bodied enough where if my son at 20 is like, yo, Pop, y'all got to run some routes. Yo, can you throw me the ball? Like, hell yeah, my shoulder still works, I took care of it, or I'm physically fit enough to catch up and be able to be with him. I don't want to ever be like, yo, my back is too fucked up, sorry, but I can't get out there, like, I can't throw the ball. Or like, my knees, or like, I got, or,
oh,
you know,
shit.
I haven't taken care of my body, so, you know, fucking high blood pressure, heart issues, you know, fucking diabetes, because my fucking shit, now I'm on insulin, all, yo, that shit is just, it's controllable, man, and it's just got to be a lifestyle, and it sucks because people don't take as much care
pass it back.
What it is, you know what I'm saying? But that's another reason why I stopped smoking, nigga, because niggas is being lazy and shit. Niggas go to Wii Fit.
I didn't say that.
I did not echo that statement.
You don't say it.
So,
but you
so,
do.
So,
you
so to answer your question,
you do go to that gym, though.
Listen. to answer your question, though, Ev, in terms of, like, the things that I have set and the goals that I have, it's weird. I had to take a more unique approach, because I tried to do like all the traditional things that people said. And then I realized like those type of habits weren't working for me, like writing things down, you know, buying a calendar and writing shit out, boom, 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 boom. So I did something that where it's just, it, I know myself, and I know I have easy access to it. And as simple as it sounds, I just put a lot of my shit in apps, inside of a, inside of a folder that's right there on the front of my page. So every time I look at my phone, I see it, so I can't avoid it.
Yeah.
You know, like all of my banking shit, all of the bills that I have to pay, all of my savings accounts, all of that shit's like right there. And it's like, oh, bro, you got to do this. Like it's just like cognitive reinforcement or whatever the fuck you want to call it.
Yeah, it's like you're getting multiple, like how we talked about, you know, like getting multiple like stimuli of it.
Right. To get it so done. You know what I mean? So like now, like it's like, you know, I'm so accustomed to having, you know, I'm so accustomed to having like that Twitch to, you know, pick up my phone and go out to social media.
Yeah.
I'm now developing that Twitch to take out my phone and go into the shit that I have to do.
Right.
So it's like, you know, yeah, so it's like I'm manipulating my own addictions.
Hack it, baby. Yeah. Hack the fuck out of you.
Because it's like you got to know yourself and you got to know what's going to make you mind to. You what? What the
look at my background. Look at my background. They're all. Look, that's my screenshotted background.
Sir, my shit organized like shit. And you're up there too, right? Talking about, you know what I'm saying?
Screenshotted background. Just like this dude.
You can't joke with Nick.
No, we out here. You know what I'm saying? We out here. But it's like little things like that. So it's like that's how I can stay on top of the things because you know it's a habit that I started to create because I didn't have it before, and it's like now I'm seeing how shit can be a little bit more structured.
Yeah.
So. Doing things like that, like, to be honest, it's like the title of our last episode. It's a brick by brick approach.
Absolutely,
like, bro,
man.
To do the same shit every day, it's going to multiply.
It has to. It's just the way the world
works. Positively or negatively, your habits are going to multiply. So.
Exactly. Either a hindrance or a helpful, right? And the funny thing about it, like, one of the things, yo, I'm going to be real with y'all. It's not that deep. It's just what I think about it. It's like a little embarrassing. So, you know, I really never made my bed until I was, like, 23. Mm. Like, I would just get out of it and just leave it like that. And my logic was, I'm going to come back to it. Nobody else is going to be in it. Why the fuck do I need to make my bed? Weird. Wild. And then I seen, like, a motivational, like, real, like, a little video. I heard it a couple times reinforced. David Goggins might have said it. And then, like, maybe an Army, Navy, or a SEAL person giving a speech. And he talked about how the first thing you do when you wake up, if you make your bed, productivity is the first thing that you're doing, and it's something where you lay your head and it's your peace. So like give yourself enough respect to allocate your time to make your place of rest. I was like, all right. It takes me like a 30 seconds. Ever since then, always made my bed. And it was weird as shit to do it. I was like, damn, it's like I'm making my bed. It was weird. It was exciting the first part. Like 30 days later, I'm like, all right, making my bed. 60 days later, making my bed. And it's like, this is natural. I fell it off a couple times. I ain't holding you. Up a couple times because now I work in my bed because we're at home, so it's weird. So it doesn't.
I'm still in these streets.
Ever. Shout out to you, motherfucker, still in the street.
I don't think a man should get pussy if he brings a chick back to the crib and his bed's not made.
Yeah,
bar.
I don't think he should get pussy. If you go out with a chick and you go out with her, you guys went to a club and she comes back to the house and she walks in your house and your shit's all nice, but you go into bed and it's just bed's just fucked all up.
Well, hold on.
Like, sheets over there, pillows hanging out throughout the bed. Right. You shouldn't get no pussy. I'm not talking about you.
No. You shouldn't get no pussy. You basically brought it up because of what I said.
Yeah, I agree with you.
At least you can do it and get your room together. Right.
And I agree with you 100%.
Yeah, but you shouldn't get no pussy.
If you're dumb enough to not know that you're about to go be with a chick and then to go make your fucking bed.
Go make your bed.
Because I ain't never, listen, I'll tell you, you want to see a nigga clean?
Get some buzzing.
Sweeping, you know, see what fucking, what's that you mean? Cinderella, you got birds coming down from the fucking outside windows, opening up your shit, folding laundry. I'm Swiffering shit, I'm spraying shit, I'm on my hands and knees.
You dancing like shit, that Mr. Clean, come on, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. Swinging the rope and shit.
Listen, that'll
you
that'll
clean like a motherfucker.
Quick as fuck.
Because you want them to walk in and be like, oh, you got a nice house. Yeah.
Smell good.
Candles burning.
Candles burning.
Houses folded, incense is burning, plan I just bought off eBay, you know what I'm saying, in the corner and shit.
House look real wholesome.
Man, take care of yourselves, man.
Like, this
and
nigga
women,
different.
Man.
You know
yeah, right.
Take care of yourselves, man. Take care of yourselves. But, you know, listen, it's all about, at the end of the day, man, you know, just, like, fucking get better. Like, get better and really be about this shit, man. Like, really, hold yourself accountable. Get a fucking accountability partner, yo, in 2021. And tell them the shit that we talked about and the accomplishments y'all want to have and the goals you got. And, motherfucker, be in each other's ass about that shit. Because that shit is real. Like, it's impacting your life. You are going to die someday. You don't know when it is. why not make the most out of your life right now with the people you have that you're blessed to have, children, family, loved ones, friends, relationship, jobs. Maximize it. I'm like, yo, bro, come the fuck on. Yo, that's why I love this quote. This is about the fuck fitness shit, you motherfucker.
I said facts.
Socrates, real quick. Run. No man has the right to be an amateur in the matter of physical training. It is a shame for a man to grow old without seeing the beauty and strength of which his body is capable, motherfucker. Mm.
He said that a thing? He said motherfucker?
No, I added that.
2020 rendition. I added that.
But yeah, seriously, man, you know, long story short, just sum it up, man. Like, really, just be about this shit. Be about this growth. Be about...
I ain't going to hold you. I'm getting ready to go to the gym right now.
Yeah.
I'm just saying it.
Got a lot of testosterone in me.
It's open. But yo, but okay, so you had shouted out a couple people, man. I know there's a couple other people who, you know, we've been blessed to be able to reach out to and, you know, kind of talk about some of the accomplishments that we have. So, you know, we got a couple people that done some big things, and we reached out and asked them to share some stuff. So, you know, for the most part, you know, just take them a little minute to shout out some people that have done some big things, right? So, Lena _, yeah, that's me. Follow. So one major accomplishment off the bat was, so she enrolled in school and she paid off her semester early. So not only did she enroll herself in school, but she put that bread down to pay it off early, and she became a business owner. So who else you got? We're gonna go like round and round.
Hey, snap. I got my man Brad.
Okay.
With 21_ Bravage. He actually graduated with, how you say it again?
Cum laude.
Cum laude honors.
Cum laude.
Cum laude honors. That's that's definitely a major accomplishment. Definitely, man. Keep on doing your thing.
Good
love
shit,
you. You know what I'm saying? Carson Wentz's ass. You know.
Wow.
I'm sorry. It's an ongoing conversation.
Man,
he's been running from
man,
me. I'm sorry. He's been running from me. He's been running from me. I'm
I
sorry.
I
wanted to shout out my homie in Cleveland. You know, fuck the Browns. Since he made the team and shit. But no, on the real, yo, I gotta shout him out because, you know, he's definitely somebody that, as you know, he's a friend of mine. But he's, you know, he's somebody that I look up to because he's a successful business owner. You know, he's a veterinarian out in Euclid, Ohio. The name of his clinic is Animal Medical Center.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yeah, bro. And just to throw the numbers out there, like, he eclipsed like almost like 1.5 mil in revenue, yo. Like, he's doing really well for himself. Like, you know,
my man Paulie.
Self-made. The only flaw I can really see is that he's a Browns fan. So, you know, but nobody's perfect. You know what I'm saying? Nobody's perfect.
Right, right. No doubt.
Yeah, shout out to Paul. Shout out to Paul.
Change your team affiliation.
Yeah,
Paul,
you know, he a real one.
Yeah. We got a shout out to Victoria V_Renee 7791. So she shared her findings from her thesis, professional role. So she does design and implementation for museums. Right? Mm. She's a really dope woman. Designs implementation for museums. She presented her thesis at the Empathy Summit 2020 and also had an interview with it. And it's about empathy and action. So she creates like live action shit. It's dope though. We're going to check and put a link for her or you know, her handle in there. So you guys know.
I want to shout out my homie Brandon. My homie, we met like almost like 10 years ago back in West Virginia. You met him.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely want to shout him out because if anybody out there is stuck in the grind, and, you know, you got your college degree and, you know, you're applying for job and you're not getting the opportunity, you know, my homie's definitely a testament to staying with it and eventually getting the bag that you deserve because he just secured a job. Despite 2020, you know, despite having to work from home, my man secured a job with Alliance Bernstein as an associate portfolio manager. You know, he secured his bag in 2020, so I got nothing but respect for him. That's nothing but a collect.
Amen.
That's good shit. Shout out _ Barrett. She's super proud of, after 10 years of serving as a teacher, coach, adjunct professor, diversity practitioner and teacher of secondary literacy in Newark, New Jersey and Philadelphia, PA Public Schools. And then she was, you know, studying for the GRE, preparing for the GRE. She applied to 3 Ivy League schools, got accepted into 2, and is currently finishing up her first semester at graduate school education at the University of Pennsylvania. And studying to receive her doctoral degree in reading, writing, and literacy. Black power, baby, black woman. Shout out to the Reds. And so that's another. Anybody else? We good?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, lastly, hold on. I got to shout out my homie. You know what I'm saying? He had a baby. You know what I'm saying? We got to shout him out.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. My homie T-Bone. You know what I'm saying? His lovely wife, Danielle. You know, they gave birth to a beautiful baby boy named Nolan Timothy Vernon Everett.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
You know, future lineman in the making. You know what I'm saying? He's going to follow in his dad's footsteps.
Shout out to the lineman. Discus
going. You know what I'm saying? Going to be chefing it up on the grill. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. So, oh, yeah, he do got some. Okay.
Yeah, big, yo, big yeah. Bone nice on the grill. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, definitely shout out to y'all, man. Hopefully, he grows up to be a beautiful baby boy. That's about it. Y'all good?
Yeah, we good. And of course, last but not least, y'all good? For this, our baby, our creation, our brainchild, you're going to get the real podcast. We are now up on, we're up on Spotify, we're up on Google Play, we're still waiting on Apple, iTunes, so you can listen in instead of having to watch us. I mean, I know you want to see us and shit, but sometimes you're in the road, you're driving, you know, so we're trying to cater to all avenues so y'all can dial in. Shout out to the 32 subscribers that we got for our YouTube page.
Thank you very much, y'all.
Shout out to y'all.
You know what I'm saying? We got Barrett Rosser, The Shocking Truth, Lil Mash 21, Moment, you know, MWX, Low Key. Bobby Chaz 76. So those are 32 subscribers,
Bobby.
Man.
Bobby.
You know, appreciate that. And then the 157 followers we got. Listen, we just started this like maybe a month, 2 months ago or some shit. You know, appreciate y'all showing us love and just being tuned in. Like, at the end of the day, babe, we try to get, look, we three friends, three personalities, one real, and you're going to get it, baby. The intellect, the raw, specialist, and you got the voice. I don't know about y'all, but... You just got the real.